Hello everyone, I'm Zhongzhe Hu, a PhD candidate from ICT CES. Today I will present MegTaiChi, a dynamic tensor-based memory management optimization for the DNN training. The key feature of MegTaiChi is that it makes memory management decision based on dynamic tensor access pattern tracked at the runtime. The experimental results show MegTaiChi can reduce the memory footprint effectively and supports larger batch size and models. Firstly, let's look at the memory wall in pre-training for deep learning. Memory limitation has become a critical bottleneck hindering the development of GAN DNN models. The model size is growing exponentially. The average model size has increased 40 times every 18 months, and in recent 2 years, the average model size has increased 340 times every 18 months, but the DRAM memory only increased 2 times every 2 years. Secondly, too large model will make it impossible to use the ideal batch size, which will affect the accuracy of the model. As shown in the figure, the main memory consumption in deep learning training comes from four spaces: parameters, optimizer variables, intermediate values, and workspace for kernel implementations. When a model contains a large number of parameters or is trained with a larger batch size, the larger number of intermediate results generated in the forward and backward calculations can lead to a severe memory shortage, as shown on the left or in the figure. Except for x and w, the rest of the value are generated at runtime, which can lead to 3 to 4 times more runtime memory than the model itself. Current neural network training is abstracted into the form of a computational graph. SCG is suitable for optimizing static neural networks such as TensorFlow, which can take into account both memory consumption and performance due to the global graph information held before runtime. You can use optimization of operations such like in-place and operator fusion and static memory planning. However, as DNN model become more flexible, such as dynamic DNN model, the optimization of memory on static graph can no longer satisfy the current model development, which led to the rapid rise of DCG style frameworks such as PyTorch dynamic graph are more challenging because of the imperative runtime. The most common memory optimization technique is tensor remasterization for static computational graph, as shown in the figure, which is to evict some intermediate tensor by forward computation. For example, by releasing the intermediate tensor or swap it to the host side memory, and as the backward needs to reuse the tensor evicted, the backward will remasterize them. SCG style deep learning framework can use global graph information to generate a checkpoint plan by global planning before model execution. This is like saving a checkpoint on a computational graph. Tensor remasterization on SCG on static graph has a better performance advantage, but cannot take advantage of runtime information as is not friendly to dynamic neural networks. DCG can also support recomputing and swapping strategies, but cannot generate a checkpoint plan like a static computational graph in advance. Instead, they are heuristically evicted at runtime for intermediate tensors. As shown in the figure, when A plus B equals C, memory is sufficient, and when A multiplied by B equals D, the OM is triggered, and the instruction to evict tensor C is inserted dynamically to evict C from the device memory. DCG can support arbitrary models and use the runtime information, but they introduce memory defragmentation as frequently free and log memory dynamically, which severely affects performance. Tensor partition is another technique to split the model parameters into different devices, while the intermittent tensor will also be splitted into different devices for the purpose of training large models. Tensor partition mainly include data parallelism, model parallelism, pipeline parallelism. Tensor partition introduced a large number of communication operations, and different partition methods have different impact on the memory footprint. As shown in the figure, for an MLP network, the final total throughput is different for the model parallelism with row partition and column partition, respectively. While existing work only consider the communication overhead and ignores the impact of memory on the overall performance. In general, the shortcomings of existing research include SC cannot satisfy the current model development. Tensor remineralization on the DCG doesn't support multi-devices. Lacking tensor remineralization and tensor partition, joint tuning, DCG brings memory fragmentation problem. Characteristic of DNN architecture is not considered on the DCG. Next, I introduce our solution. MegTaiChi is a virtual machine module for memory management optimization on DCG by controlling tensor accesses behaviors. First, the dynamic tensor partition is proposed to determine whether or how to partition each tensor. Second, the dynamic tensor evicting is designed to determine whether or when to intercept tensor allocations, accesses, and deallocations by avoiding the release of high-frequency user data and balancing the tensor remineralization time and memory footprint. Third, the near optimal memory allocation is developed to determine the exact memory address for each tensor to make full use of the device memory of the host system by capturing and using the important invariable characteristics of DCG and avoiding the generation of memory fragments. DTP is a heuristic design for partitioning tensors. When virtual machine instructions are generated for an operator to be performed, MegTaiChi needs to determine how to execute the operator. As shown in panel 1, during the instruction generation for executing OPI plus 1, MegTaiChi applies DTP to infer the tensor partition plan of OPI plus 1 heuristically, which may need to change the partition dimension of outputs of OPI and the partition dimension of this before executing OPI plus 1. The relevant communication instruction will be generated and inserted in front of the computation instruction of OPI plus 1. DTE is an adaptive strategy for releasing tensors during the runtime. When the virtual machine instruction are executed, once the OM orcs DTE would determine which tensors should be released and whether to choose swapping or recomputing for the selected tensors. As shown in panel 2, before the execution of the original OP4, A multiplied B equals C, the current memory is greater than threshold, which states that OM happens. Immediately, the auto-evict introduction is generated and inserted into the virtual machine instruction queue, which releases some tensors from memory based on DTE. TMA is a fine-grained method for assigning memory address to all the tensors if the architecture of DNN model is fixed during the training process. The DCG would be invariable even though it is generated dynamically. During the first 5 training iterations, MegTaiChi captures the important invariable characteristic of DCG from panel 2, such as the lifespan of intermittent tensors at the training iteration. By tracing the virtual machine instruction sequence based on the invariable characteristic of DCG's TMA can establish a fine-grained memory allocation plan which would be adopted in the following epochs until the end of the training process. As shown in panel 3, using the memory requirement information, TMA simulated the memory allocation process and adjust the sorting address of some tensors in the simulation, which leads to a topological map specifying the dependency relationship between all the tensors on time and space dimensions degrees. Based on the topological map, TMA can generate a near-optimal memory allocation plan by leveraging a sort algorithm and avoid fragmentation. Next, I will show the specific implementation details of the three modules. For DDP, we first extract the partition pattern of each operator, which includes the intra-operator tensor partition pattern and the inter-operator data rearrangement pattern. For intra-operator partition, we extract four patterns: data parallelism, zero-lag data parallelism, model parallelism by row dimension, and column dimension. And because of the different strategy of data partition within different operators, communication needs to be inserted between operators to complete the data rearrangement between upstream operator output and downstream operator input. And the data rearrangement pattern between operators is slow, as shown on the table. Before the virtual machine generates the computational instruction for each operator, the operator interpreter will dynamically infer the partition strategy of the current operator by giving each pattern a score. The scoring strategy is to trade off communication and memory use, and then dynamically adjust the tensor partition strategy of the current operator according to the scoring target function, as shown in the figure. Below right, we change the original strategy based on the heuristic inference. While generating virtual machine instruction, we also insert auto-evict instruction to dynamically release and swap intermediate value to the host memory according to whether the memory triggers an OM signal, and regenerate them when needed, as it is based on the imperative runtime. We use the heuristic strategy. First, we look at the composition of the score function parameters, which mainly include the time of tensor recomposition in the candidate set and the time of swapping to the host set. The time since this tensor was last visited, the number of times the tensor has been recomputed before, the recomputation overhead of each tensor's neighbor tensors, and the size of the free memory block adjacent to the tensor. Then the evicted tensor should be tensor memory footprint as large as possible, recomputing overhead as small as possible, as long as possible since the last visited, recomputation times as many as possible, adjacent position as free as possible. We use a heuristic strategy to dynamically score the tensor to evict and minimize the scoring function. In the heuristic function, we consider the optimization of memory fragmentation. As shown in the figure, by DTE strategy, we can see the state and lifetime of each tensor in the memory in one iteration. The y-axis indicates tensor ID. The x-axis indicates the timeline in one iteration. Red indicates the tensor resize in memory. Green indicates the tensor is released in forward. Blue indicates the tensor is released in backward. For the TMV module, which is an optimization module designed for static neural network, DDP and DTE support arbitrary network architectures. If the trained network is a static neural network, the interpreter captures the execution sequence of the operators and the traceable access sequence through the warm-up phase. For untraceable access sequence, such as the gradient, we will open up a separate space for storing them. Since the operators of a static neural network don't change during each iteration, therefore, a static memory plan can be reformulated for the access sequence by simulating the memory access process. During the simulation, we define six optimization rules, as shown in the figure, as the logic of free and lock. Panel 1 lock a new memory chunk separately. Panel 2 allocate a memory chunk from idle queue, allock and division. Panel 3 allocate a memory chunk from idle queue and swell it. Panel 4 free up specific chunks. Panel 5 free up specific chunks and merge adjacent free chunks. Panel 6 allocate a new memory chunk and overwrite its dependent chunk. Six optimization rules are motivated by memory reuse and minimizing memory fragmentation. If the DTE is turned on after a few iterations warm up, the virtual machine will reorder the above original access sequence, which will be used as the input of TMA. After TMA applies six optimization rules to optimizing the simulation, it will get the new relative position of each tensor and record the relative topological relationship between the tensors and generate the topological map to replan and output the starting address of each tensor in the memory. The TMV simulation optimization is performed only once. Let's show how TMA replan memory allocation with a simple example. Suppose we capture the following access sequence by warming up a few iterations as shown in figure. First will be a location 1, location 2, and reorder and update the relative position of the tensor and the topological graph. The below I reorder the set of history pre-tensors of each tensor. Then we allocation 3, reorder and update the relative position of the tensor and the topological graph. Then 3, 2, reorder and update the relative position of the tensor and the topological graph. Note that at this point in allocation of 4, as the original sequence does not have a new free block to place 4, original operation will open up a new memory space, but in the simulation, TMA will choose to swell space to space. In the simulation, TMA will choose to swell space 2. To save memory as well as to avoid fragmentation, and then update the relative position and the topological map. Then 3, 1, reorder and update the relative position of the tensor and the topological graph. When allocate file reuse the memory block of one. Update the relative position and the topological graph, and finally, topological sort to get the starting address of each sensor. We provide a simple API interface, a few lines of code to achieve the above optimization. The largest experimental platform we use is a private cloud platform with 256 GPUs. The test data used includes synthetic data and face recognition data. The test neural networks include mainstream CV and ARP networks. The baseline we test include PyTorch DTR, Caption, and Sublinear. Where PyTorch DTR does not support multi-device training and Caption is not open source, so we implemented an optimal version named MegCaption and MegDDR. Compared with data parallel, the contribution of DDP on performance improvement is slightly for ResNet 50 model, while DDP achieved average 1.4 performance speedup for VGG16, GL-based, and GL-large model respectively. The main reason is that ResNet 50 is a convolution-dominated network which prefers data parallelism. Other networks contain many FC layers prefer the model parallelism. In DTE and plus DTMA evaluation, the memory consumption can be reduced to a quarter with double the performance loss compared to naive baseline on the dynamic computational graph. Compared to sublinear, it is not as fast as sublinear, but reduce memory consumption to one half. MegTaiChi performs 1.2 to 1.9 better than the competition on a single device and 1.2 to 1.5 better than the competition on multi-devices. Compared to baseline, which increases the battery size by 4.1 to 7 times on the test model. It is clear that compared with PyTorch DTR, TMA result in less memory fragments. Due to this fact, the peak memory usage as shown is reduced by 11% for ResNet 50 and 10.5% for GL-based respectively, which is a significant achievement for the memory optimization based on DCG and TMA mix defragmentation untriggered. The runtime overhead of MegTaiChi is less than 5% of the runtime in one iteration. As shown in the figure, compared with FlashFlow, G-Shot, and 0.3, MegTaiChi achieves 1.2, 1.8, and 1.5 times performance speedup, respectively, on average. FlashFlow and G-Shot try to explore the parallelism of multi-dimension tensor partition on SCG. However, MegTaiChi abstracts the tensor partition pattern to immediately generate the memory optimization plan on DCG, leading to the better behavior on the memory usage. 0.3 manages the memory usage by manually tuning tensor remasterization and tensor partition, but 0.3 doesn't focus on the performance optimization of tensor remasterization and tensor partition behaviors. However, MegTaiChi automatically combines the tensor partition with tensor remasterization to determine the near-optimal memory management plan on DCG, which could achieve high performance. Compared with sublinear, on a single device, the performance is about the same as sublinear and supports larger batch size. Eventually, MegTaiChi achieved 1.87 times the speed up on face recognition application. For conclusion, this work proposed MegTaiChi, a dynamic tensor-based memory management optimization module for the DNN training, which achieves an efficient coordination of tensor partition and tensor rematerialization, specifically DTP, DTE, and TMA, are designed for the heuristic, adaptive, and fine-grained memory management. The experimental results confirm the high performance of MegTaiChi. Thank you for listening to my speech.